안녕하세요. 이번 주 셀프 카메라는 저 전지현입니다.
전지현. If you have been following Korean drama or movies, you would have known her from My Sassy Girl. 전지현 was born in Seoul, South Korea on 30th October 1981, which makes her a Scorpio. She was born with the name Wang Ji-hyun. She is 173cm tall. Her favorite color is white, favorite actress is Kim Hee-ae, and favorite song is To Mother by G.O.D. She has an older brother, and her best friend is Lee Young-ae. She wanted to become a flight attendant, but she gave up after a bad flight experience. She was encouraged by her mother to pursue modeling or acting career due to her slim figure. In 1997, she started her career as a model for Ecole magazine at the age of 16. She also appeared in the music video Will You Understand by Cho Kyu-man. In 1998, she debuted as an actress and adopted the stage name Chun Ji-hyun at the suggestion of a producer. The same year, she starred in the television series Fascinate My Heart with Park Shin-young. Did you know that in 1999 she appeared in the TV series Happy Together as Lee Byung-hyun's younger sister? She also made a film debut, White Valentine, which was not very well known. Even so, she did receive the Best New Actress for this film on the 35th Baek-sung Arts Award. Then she actually became popular after a Samsung MyJet printer commercial. The dancing and attitude expressed in the ad became iconic for Koreans in their late teens and early 20s at the time. She also appeared in the music video The Beginning of Love by Leon Lai. The Hollywood film The Lake House starring Keanu Reeves and Sandra Bullock was actually a remake of Il Mare, a film Chun Ji-hyun starred in 2000. The film was set in Ganghwa Island and did respectably well at the box office despite opening on the same day as blockbuster movie Joint Security Area. She appeared in two music videos, Hey Girl and Love of the Sun and the Moon, both projects by Jang Hyuk. In 2002, her breakout film, My Sassy Girl, became the highest-grossing Korean comedy of all time in Korea and also spent 2 weeks in the number one spot in Hong Kong, making her one of the biggest Hallyu stars in the Chinese language market. The huge success of My Sassy Girl proves her popularity and was given the title of Nation's First Love. Chun Ji-hyun's growing popularity resulted in many companies requesting her endorsement. She also appeared in music video Love is Always Thirsty by Yumi. In 2002, she won the Best Actress at the Grand Bell Awards. In 2003, Chun Ji-hyun starred in the psychological thriller film The Uninvited, which was rather well received by critics but failed to catch on with audience. During this time, she was constantly appearing in TV ads and on billboards in Korea and also in many other Asian countries. In 2004, she reunited with the director of My Sassy Girl and starred as a policewoman in the romantic comedy Windstruck. Personally, we think her role is too similar to My Sassy Girl. Despite that, Windstruck became the best performing Korean film in Japan, where surprisingly My Sassy Girl was not as well known. In the same year, she graduated with a bachelor's degree in theater and film at Dongguk University. In 2005, she was ranked among the top 10 most bankable stars in South Korea. In 2006, she portrayed an artist in the film Daisy alongside Jung Woo-sung, who she frequently appeared together in advertisements. The film Daisy grew a lot of attention for its 100% location shooting in the Netherlands and for using the Hong Kong director Andrew Lau from Infernal Affairs. Then she made a jump into Hollywood as the lead in Blood the Last Vampire, a live-action adaptation of a popular Japanese anime. For this role, she went through 3 months of hard training to play the sword-wielding heroine. It was at this time she went by the westernized name Gianna June. Chun Ji-hyun then launched her own luxury jeans brand in 2008 named Gianna by True Religion, her first celebrity line. For the film A Man Who Was Superman, Chun Ji-hyun played a cynical documentary producer. Initially, she felt pressured at the opportunity to work with acclaimed actor Hwang Jun-min. She said, "Although luck was probably involved, I think it's destiny for an actor to meet new work. On the first day I met him, I realized that I have much to learn from him, not only his acting but also as an individual." In 2010, she acted in the film Snowflower and the Secret Fan, which was based on the Lisa See's best-selling novel, opposite Chinese actress Li Bingbing. In 2011, she obtained a master's degree at Dongguk University's Digital Media and Contents. In 2012, Chun Ji-hyun was a scene stealer in Choi Dong-hoon's heist film The Thieves. It was about thieves from Korea and China who teamed up together to steal a diamond locked up in a special room at a casino in Macau. The film became the second top-selling Korean film of all time. In the same year, she tied the knot with her husband, Choi Jun-hyuk, a banker and grandson of a famous hanbok designer in Seoul. They got married at the Sheila Hotel. Many celebrities were present. In 2013, she played a translator married to a North Korean intelligence agent in The Berlin File. She was praised for her action scenes and North Korean dialect. 14 years after Happy Together in 1999, Chun Ji-hyun finally made her return to television in the fantasy romance My Love from the Star opposite Kim Soo-hyun. The series was a rating success. sparking fashion trends, makeup, and restaurants. The drama re-established Chun Ji-hyun as the leader of the Hallyu and was given several awards. In 2015, she played a sniper who assembles a squad of independent fighters to kill a Japanese commander and a pro-Japanese Korean business tycoon in the film Assassination, another successful film that became the highest-grossing Korean film of the year. She was pregnant when she filmed this movie. Chun Ji-hyun was awarded Best Actress at the Grand Bell Awards and Max Movie Awards. In 2016, she made her small-screen comeback yet again in The Legend of the Blue Sea with Lee Min-ho. Chun Ji-hyun ranked 9th on Gallup Korea's list of 10 best actors of 2016, becoming the only woman to be included. She also gave birth to a son on 10th February 2016. Through 2014 to 2017, she was listed in Forbes as Korea Power Celebrity. In 2018, she gave birth to her second son on 26th January. In 2020, Chun Ji-hyun made a short appearance in the second season of Kingdom. She was later confirmed to reprise her role and lead the series' special episode Kingdom, Ashen of the North, along her assassination co-star, Park Byung-eun. It is set to air on the 23rd of July 2021. She was also confirmed to perform in Cliffhanger later this year, written by Kingdom screenwriter Kim Min-hee, opposite Joo Ji-hoon. These projects will mark her small screen comeback after 5 years of hiatus. Her estimated net worth is said to be about $6 million. She currently has 450,000 followers on Instagram. Which is your favorite Chun Ji-hyun? Leave us a comment below and it will really help our channel. Thank you so much for your support.